Well, Father's Day, it is this Sunday, but don't waste your money on socks and jocks. Get Dad a gift that he really wants. Yes, Henry, write it down. It's a good book. That can really take him places, and Steve Cox is from Dymocks and he's here to talk us through some of the best books out there. Welcome to the show.
Good morning. Good morning. Thank you. Thank you. Great to be here.
Blokes would really prefer a book over a bad tie, right?
Absolutely. So the Omnichannel poll that was done back end of last year showed that 2/3 of men still absolutely love to read a great book, and it's by far and away one of their most popular gifts as well. 50 to 60% of men saying they would love a book for Father's Day. So they're a great gift, and there's so much to them. You know, it's I think that's why they're so far ahead of their tie and the socks and jocks.
Exactly.
So what do you reckon's going to be the best sellers for this Father's Day?
Look, we've got a number of great sellers for this Father's Day, and we've brought a few around today. I mean, if I have a look at sort of the Bomber Thompson story.
Oh, yes.
But I think for cooking, you've got Jamie Oliver. So if you start with Jamie Oliver, so for the dad that likes to cook, like myself, you can't go wrong with the Jamie Oliver.
He does brilliant recipes.
That's exactly right.
And he's a dad of five, isn't he? So he's a perfect candidate.
He is. Family foods. This is all great healthy cooking, really, really fantastic meals. It's got all the nutritional information in there, tips and tricks about how to get veg and all those sorts of things into the family meal. So it's a wonderful, wonderful book for Father's Day. You couldn't go far wrong with that one.
There's another fabulous one about wine too.
Yeah, we like James Halliday. Over 30 years now recommending wines for Australians. So this is the go-to book for any dad that loves his wine. It's got all the ratings, all of the information with relation to the vineyards, all the details that you would ever need to know. It is definitely the go-to book.
It is fantastic. And wine is also a great way to convince your wife you don't have a drinking problem. Yeah. Now, Peter Grester, incredible journalist and an amazing story to tell, Steve. Tell us a bit about...
Look, this is the book's called Freeing Peter. So this has just come out. This is Peter Grest and his family. They've written it together. This is an amazing story. So Peter, of course, was with the Al Jazeera network, and he and two colleagues were arrested. There was a sham trial, no evidence presented apparently, and he was arrested to 7 years in prison.
Seven years.
So he spent 400 days in, and this is written from the perspective of all his family members and himself, from the way they kept it in the front page of the news to ultimately get him out, but also about Peter talking about his own, trying to stop getting his own solitary confinement in his mental and his mind and how he overcame that as well. So it's a really compelling story about the family interactions, you know, the wins and the losses as they went through this whole process, and ultimately how they were successful to free Peter from you know, just a terrible position to be in an Egyptian prison with very few rights. And, I think it's a great read for Father's Day. It's Australian, of course, and, you know, it's something that's really quite unique.
What about new fiction books and dads that love a thriller?
Sure. Daniel Silver, The Black Widow. This is the one to go with. So this is the 16th book by Daniel Silver of the Gabrielle Allon character. Now, he's a New York Times bestseller, and whilst it's a fictional book, if you sort of hear a bit about the plot, it unfortunately rings too many bells. So this is bombing in Paris, ISIS plot.
Right.
Quite up-to-date and topical, if you like. So it's a page-turner. It's one for the dad. If you give this to him, he won't put it down until, you know, soon after Father's Day.
Fantastic. And, Steve, of course, as you know, I'm a natural athlete. And you've also got something for sports fans.
The sports fans. Look, this one, particularly for the AFL fans, Bomber Thompson.
The Essendon fans.
Essendon fans, Geelong fans. And I think...
Essendon fans.
And I think AFL fans in general. I mean, this is... his story, right through to, of course, the controversial drug saga at Essendon. But, I mean, Bomber Thompson was an amazing player. Three premierships for Essendon, two as coach of Geelong, then went on to the Essendon Football Club. Talks about how he's dealt with that whole period
of really
time.
Got really screwed over, in my opinion. But anyway, that's...
And interesting, a lot of people think that his name Bomber comes from his time at Essendon, which, of course, are the Essendon Bombers. But in actual fact, it was from, just reading the book, a story of him having to go over the fence and get the ball when he's playing backyard football, and his next door neighbour is a Russian lady with a very aggressive dog, and he had to run across and grab the ball and then hide and then sort of do this bomber run back. So that's where his nickname came from.
So you train all footy players that way.
Yeah,
not enough wild dogs used in footy training.
Not enough wild dogs for the skill and agility. Another great read for the sports fan.
Fantastic. Lots of ideas to keep Dad happy this Sunday. Steve, thanks so much for coming in.
Thank you so much.